First of all, David, thank you, for joining me this morning.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Right. What country are you in? What country do you live in now?
I'm in Nigeria. I'm living in Nigeria.
Right. Excellent. Thank you. Tell me something. How easy is it for a foreigner to start a business, or for that matter, how easy is it for a local to start a business in Nigeria these days?
Well, looking at the scenario of starting from getting an incorporations, getting your company registered as an incorporation in Nigeria is very easy compared to other ones. In the maximum of a month to get your registrations done, so with a minimum of, let's say, a minimum of $300 to get your limited liability company.
All right.
So looking at this environment, it gives a kind of room to our investors and whoever wants to come in to have a good and easy access to register their company, even if it's both to non-indigent and the indigent of the country.
Right.
So, with this aspect, the aspect of registrations, of getting yourself involved as a liability a limited liability company in Nigeria, is very, very easy, and the cost is very minimum. Then talking about the tax, talking about the taxations, Nigeria is one of the lowest country that has is one of the country that has lowest taxation charges compared to other countries.
Lowest taxation charges.
So, yes, that's when you say whatever, like a return tax, for example, when you're a bill or you are a vendor who is buying something from a supplier, your taxation, your VAT fee for that such transaction is just 5%.
That's good.
So these are the advantage and the merits that is an accumulative tube,
right,
to whoever is coming as an investor to see as an advantage in the getting a business in Nigeria.
And what type of businesses are what are the businesses that are most lucrative in Nigeria? Let's say if you're someone like myself who wants to come to the country, what businesses or problems, should I say, need to be solved in your country?
The first priority now that is even that our present administration, the present administrations, which is under the president, Buhari, they encourage agriculture sector.
Oh, okay.
And yes, agriculture is one of the fastest and growing sector now, which the government have much more interest in, which they are working on, both even investors coming in as has a support and a very good environment for the investments of such investors to take place. So every state is encouraged, every state, every local government is encouraged by the federal government of Nigeria to embark on agriculture. So mere looking at this is an advantage for whomever is coming in, is an advantage for any investors coming in into Nigeria, because it will have every right and support from the government.
I see. So if I'm an outsider, like an African American, could you shed some light on the experience for an immigrant like myself who would be moving to Nigeria? What kind of steps or processes would someone have to come, would have to deal with, let's say if they're coming to just retire as opposed to say coming to do business? Is there a difference?
Well, if you are coming in as an investor, like I said, mm-hmm. the present administrations, they are doing so very much the creative and hard work in that sector of encouraging investors mm-hmm. to coming into the country. Mm-hmm. So with this, it is very easy. I would say it is very easy in Nigeria for a non-residential or an investor to come in mm-hmm. and set up his investment mm-hmm. with a very good atmospheric environment mm-hmm. that will enable and secure the project or whatever investment investors are bringing in. For example, if you are coming as a non-indigent to the country mm-hmm. for to come and invest,
right?
The first thing is that the local company mm-hmm. who is trying to that the foreign investors is mm-hmm. coming through needs to assess the foreign the foreign investment mm-hmm. The foreign investment let's say the foreign investment foreign affairs ministry under the investment commission mm-hmm. for the necessary procedures mm-hmm. and for the necessary engagement with the government that will enable such investors to have the adequate information of what he is coming to do mm-hmm. in the country before coming. That is the first stage.
Right.
The second stage is when the information is is passed to the investors from the Foreign Affairs Commission and the Investment Commission of Nigeria from Nigeria, the second stage is for the local company to invite to send an official invitation
right.
for the foreign investors to come in into the country
mm-hmm.
to do a kind of assess of visibility studies of what he wants to come and invest on.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, you have, during the visibility studies, you have the privilege to for example, if you are staging your investment, for example, in Lagos State or Ogun State,
mm-hmm.
you need to visit such investment commission agency for the government for an face-to-face interactions to get more information. Then after that, when you're convinced and you're satisfied with the promises and what the information you've gotten from the government and you're satisfied, the next thing is how you set up your local company.
Okay. And generally speaking, how quickly does it take, how much time does it take to set up an average corporation in Nigeria?
Well, the maximum, mm-hmm. the maximum is a month.
Okay.
The minimum is 3 months. Yeah, it's 3 weeks.
The
maximum is 1 month.
Okay, well, yes. that's good. Tell me something. Is there a minimum or maximum amount of money you have to bring to the table in order to be considered an investor?
Well, what is just there is that if you want to be for an investor coming in,
mm-hmm.
you can have your what is it called? You can have your a proof of funds,
right?
Maybe your money is offshore.
Mm-hmm.
Then you're coming in as an investor, and because the most especially, it is advisable for an investor to partner to have the concept of maybe some a kind of government input in your investment, because that will create a less dividends of tax section,
mm-hmm.
and it will also give more dividends to the investors because it's involving the government. And the government will enable to provide good securities, you understand, to make sure that the investors are secured. So that is why it is advisable for an investor coming in to also, you know, let the government to also, maybe in the aspect of land contributions to the investment, that you involve the government, so that the government, when you've involved the government will provide a very good, conducive and security environment that will enhance, you know, the investors. You understand? To secure its interest and generate good income, because you are establishing a kind of you are creating a job, you are creating an employment to the environment, which the government will see as an opportunity to also give the maximum and necessary support for the investment to commence. So that is one of the importance for investors to have the consent and some kind of equity contribution from the government. Mm-hmm. So that the benefit can be more proactive for the investors.
Well, that's good. So you're telling me, you're telling us that the Nigerian government is willing to partner with potential investors, essentially.
Yes, in agriculture and in some other areas.
Okay, well, that's good. You mentioned land earlier in your comment. How hard or easy is it for any foreigner coming into the country either to buy land or acquire land from traditional chiefs, either for, say, retirement or for business or for both? What are the options?
Okay. The option is that the first thing that needs to be considered is know whom you are dealing with. Mm-hmm. The first thing is when you are connected to the right people, that's the first source that leads to the success of getting for foreigners or investors to get access. So that is one of the source, the key points to the success of getting or purchasing a land in Nigeria. Because when you know the person you are dealing with and is a very direct contact that is giving you the right information at the right time, then getting the land is very easy.
Okay.
So yes, getting the land is very easy once you are connected to the right part. So then when you are connected to the right part, the next thing is you engage with the traditional leaders of such, for example, when you have a community, this community has a very huge mass of land to sell outrightly. Mm-hmm. What you do is just that you engage the chiefs. You see the head, for example, there are some families that own the land, and there are some. And within that community, there is a king or chiefs, head chiefs, that control that locality. The first thing you need to do is you visit the chief or the king of that vicinity to assess the information given to you from your local partners concerning the information of the land that you want to purchase. Then the chief, with his own ancient history that he has and with his own knowledge of history that he has as a king or as a head of the community, you will be able to assess the information directly from such king or chiefs. Then from there, from there you've assessed the information given to you. Then when the information is intact with what you've accumulated from from your local partner that is bringing you, that is giving you the connections. You understand? Then when you assess, then the next stage is to visit the family. The king, the chiefs, invites the family to his palace or to his office. Then from there, you discuss. Then the next thing, when after your discussions, you go to the you look to the state where the community is based. For example, if there is a community based in under jurisdiction of Lagos State, for example, after meeting with the families, the owners, and the chief, and discussion of the land, the next thing is for you to go and do search from the government.
Okay.
From the government covers. There is a Ministry of Lands. You go to the Ministry of Lands, you do your assessment, you check on that land, because you'll have gotten some documents from the, for example, the survey plan of the land.
Mm-hmm.
Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
You get the survey plan. Yeah, you get the survey plan of the land. You went to the Ministry of Lands of such state. You do your verification whether the land is an is free from government or is under government. Then when the land is free, the government has given you that a report on the land, that the land is free from government, is free from this. Then now go back to the chiefs and to the traditional leaders and the community leaders to finalize your negotiations concerning the purchase of the land. Then from there, the times of document signing and money exchange and commerce. So those are that is the way you can acquire land.
Excellent, thank you. Tell me something. To your knowledge, are expats from America, African Americans, are they welcome to return to Nigeria?
Yes, because there is President Trump said when he gets into the office, he also mentioned something like this, that the Africans and the Nigerians that are in US should go back and develop their country, which we here in Nigeria, let's say 80% of the populations of the masses of Nigeria are also keenly interested. For example, there are a lot of private individuals, investors that are coming in form of to fund some startups, organizations, or startup company, in terms of giving them some funds to raise their project from a startup position. So and the government also is open to receive as much as Americans, the Nigerian or African Americans, Nigerians citizens that are in US, to receive them back home, so that they can build the country. So there is no discrimination in Nigeria. There is no law that goes against any that says that a non-Nigerian or an American or a Nigerian American should not come back home for investment.
Excellent. Tell me something. What do you think is the easiest thing to adjust to for, say, an African American coming back to live in Nigeria? What would be the easiest thing they could find that would be easiest to adjust to in a new lifestyle there?
Okay. Now, for example, the easiest things that they need to do is they should try and find a kind of lucrative small scales business, like for example, in the terms of let's say in the terms of, let's say, exporting of crops, like all these agro crops, like what is it called, sesame seeds?
Yes.
Maize, you know, they have their seasons, cashew nuts, and all these kind of things, which have seasons. One comes after the others. Exportation of palm oil, which can also be, which can, you know, you can start with, it doesn't require a lot of processing.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't require a lot of processing. So it's an exportation, what's it called, business of all these agricultural products to Asia, America, Europe, or wherever, any part in the world. The second thing is that then they can also try to venture into communication business, mm-hmm, as well, because the populations of the customers or the end user of internet with phones or whatever stuff or gadget of communications, mm-hmm, increases.
Mm-hmm.
Increases every day by day, it increases. So the that is one aspect. The third aspect is they can also go into transportation business, which, right, for example, the Lagos State, it's also trying to encourage some private people to also to partner with them. Maybe you have, for example, in Lagos metropolitan cities, every place across the bus stops of each local government under the government of the Excellency Akinwumi Ambode is trying to renovate and restructure every point of the bus stop of the entire state to standard, upgrading them to the standard, making sure that the transportation system in Nigeria, in Lagos State per se, is effective. And to this, he encouraged a lot of people, the private owners, to come and partner with the government. Maybe, for example, you have the power to bring like 5 buses, 3 buses, 2 buses, 10 buses joined to the government. There is a way and there is a scheme that is ventures for such kind of investors to recoup his money back daily or monthly, depends on how the negotiations goes with the government.
I see.
And many other ways.
Yeah, what would be the most, one of the most difficult things that foreigners, people would have to adjust to coming to Nigeria, in your opinion?
Okay, the most difficult thing is that a foreigner that is coming should be, should be financially buoyant.
Mm-hmm.
Should be financially buoyant, yes. And because in the world in Nigeria, as to say, there's a lot of scenarios that has make an investors to be an enemy to some of the promoter of the investors to the government, because most of investors just come in, they fly in, and at the end of the day, if they ask them to show a kind of proof of funds of what they are coming to do, none of them have such, they don't have any documents, no any other things to show. So how do you want the government to welcome such of that kind of an investor that is unable to provide a kind of documentation that really shows that he has the capability to invest in a project or to invest in a country? So that is the most difficult things that an investor needs,
mm-hmm,
to work on, because if an investor or a foreigner is financially buoyant, to do an investment or any kind of or to venture any innovations in the country, in Nigeria as I speak, such investors will be highly welcome into the society.
Excellent, thank you.
And we get the support.
Well, that's good. Can you share a few details about the cost of living in Nigeria?
The cost of living?
Yes. For example,
it depends.
Mm-hmm. Like for example, getting an apartment or buying or a house, for example, what kind of experiences would someone like myself have coming into Nigeria? Would they be able to get affordable housing at reasonable costs, or is there a Nigerian real estate bubble, or what would you say?
Yeah, there's a real estate. There's an estate that is owned by the government, which you can also buy an apartment or something like that. But in some, it depends on the area. For example, in Lagos State, if you are getting an apartment in Lagos State, it is not advisable for new investors to go to the island. To get an apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Even it is a no-go area for an investor to even said he wants to buy house there. Talk less of to even rent, or talk less of saying he wants to buy, because the price there is not affordable. When you go in there today, a lot of people are now moving. Most of the houses there are vacant.
Uh-huh.
They are now moving to the mainland. They are moving to the mainland because the price is too exorbitant.
Mm-hmm.
So when you want to minimize your cost, it depend. In Nigeria, there is no certain amount, because the cost of living can be determined.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Can be determined by the choice of the investors that is coming in. Because some of the investors might say, no, look, this is what I, you know, but for me, to the scenario, because I've engaged with a lot of people that I've brought in an Israeli to this country, I've brought in a Chinese firm to this country, I've brought a Korean firm to this country, even Swedish, and, you know, there's a lot of things that when we discuss at last, when they have to come to my opinion, because I live here, and I always promote any investors that is coming as a partner or that is coming through me to achieve and to maximize his profit. That is to secure the investors' interest first, so that when the investors grows, I can as well achieve from his growth. You understand? That is the basic of my own foundations. So, for that reason, there is the cost of living depends on the choice of each. It depends on the choice of an investor. So the cost of living in mainland with a good apartment and every other place is okay. Like, for example, the area I live, it is an estate.
Mm-hmm.
And the cost of getting a two-bedroom flat, an mm-hmm. apartment, and it's a very secured area in mainland.
Mm-hmm.
It's very close to the sectarian government. Very right. close to the sectarian government, and we have constant power. So for example, getting a two-bedroom flat in that vicinity is not less than 1.5 million naira.
Okay.
a good apartment of 1 million to 1.5 million, a good, very good one in that area.
Is that
for a year, month? For per annum.
So the cost of 1 million on one
per annum.
Right. Is that for a year or what?
Yes, a year per annum.
Oh, okay.
Per annum.
Per annum. Oh, okay. Understood. Thank you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So like I said, so there's a lot of ways to minimize and a lot of way to go about the cost, irrespective of the cooperative of the investors. Mm-hmm. Understand? Some investors, like I said, their choice determines the cost of their living. So for example, Ikeja is a very, there are a lot of places as well in Abuja and some other state as well, but the most place that is good for investors to live and to transact their business is, for example, if you are coming to Nigeria as an investor on agriculture, it is very advisable for such investors to stay in Lagos, to live in Lagos and find an habitat of mass of land in Ogun State, because the distance between Ogun State and Lagos State is not, let's say, 150 kilometers. So it is very advisable for investors to stay either in Abuja or Lagos.
Oh, okay. Let me ask you something. What type of timetable do you think is required just to gain residency in Nigeria?
Well, what is needed? For example, it is something that can be done
mm-hmm.
through the process of your registration.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Your company incorporation.
Okay.
Yes, it can, because when registering your company shows your company to invest, and this will also prove and fasten the way your residence in the country.
Right.
Because when you're just coming, if you're coming as a personal person and you say you want to get residence, before you can get the approval, might be longer. It might took time. But when you are coming, when you are doing your residence in line with your incorporation, it is very easy.
I see.
You can get it along. Yes, you can get it along with your incorporation. Yes.
So you can get it along with your incorporation. Is that's what you're saying?
Yes, you can get it along with your corporation.
Okay. Suppose you just want to come to Nigeria and get residency to retire. What conditions would apply there?
To retire in where?
Any part of Nigeria, for example, that you can suggest.
Okay, that you just want to come in without any investment.
Right, because
is that what you're saying?
Yes, some people might want to come just to retire, just to get away from the West. What would you suggest about the issues regarding residency under those conditions?
For such conditions, you need to be attached. You need to be attached to an indigenous company here in Nigeria.
All right.
Yes, you need to be attached to an indigenous company in Nigeria that will fasten, maybe one or two ways. Assess you as present you to the government as one of the foreign partners that are coming to support your business and the local business or something like that, then those are the other ways that you can use. A very good accessible way is by for a local partner here to assess you in his company and present you to the government as one of the corporators, the partners. Then from there, you can also get your residence.
Okay, well, that's great. What about travel issues around Nigeria? How easy is it to fly in and out of the country or travel by roads or rail around Nigeria? What would you say?
I'm happy for this question. Mm-hmm. Do you know why?
Under the
able president of General Muhammadbey, who is a very tough man, that is trying to put the country into order with all his efforts.
Mm-hmm.
He has tried to complete some about 2 to 3 trains system fixed that are walking from one state to the interstate, you know, putting a kind of and while others are still going on, a lot of projects on that train system are going on. So now for these reasons, flying out from one state to the other is very easy in Nigeria.
Excellent.
Because there's a lot the flying system here works 24 hours.
Okay.
They work 24 hours. Yes, they fly in the night. They fly anytime, and most of the states now, some of the states that did not have airports. Mm-hmm. They are now putting the facilities together to get their own airport, and they love a lot of airports that serves. Mm-hmm. At least we have local airports more than up to 10.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Up to 10. So yes, the flying from one state to the other is very easy. And talking about the road network,
right?
It is not advisable for a foreign partner to go or travel from one state to another in some part of the state through road. For example, if you are traveling for Lagos to Abuja, it is not advisable for a foreign partner to travel through the road. But if you are traveling from Lagos to Ogun State or your state, you can still, it is still doable. You can travel within the west, southwest, through road. You can travel through the southwest, within the southwest region, which comprises of 6 states, Lagos, Ogun, Oyo, Osun, Kwara, Osun, Kwara, and one other states like that, Ekiti, Ondo, Kwara is not there, Ondo. So those are the places you can still go through the road.
Understand.
So, but if you're traveling from the southwest to the north central, or from southwest to the northeast or northwest, it is not advisable to go through the road.
All right.
Because the road network is not too good.
Aside from traveling by plane, are there alternatives to traveling by road in Nigeria?
Yes. Yes, there are other alternatives to travel by road.
Mm-hmm. Like what?
Now,
like what, for example?
You can only travel maybe through the train.
Mm-hmm.
If you can travel in some part of the state now, you can travel from Lagos to Ibadan through the train.
Okay. Would you say that the train service is scheduled to improve in the near future?
I can't say that actually, because the service of that train just commenced some few months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And by so doing I cannot assess them, because I don't know how effective is the service, you understand. Mm-hmm. I can't really say everything mm-hmm. about the service. But there are some also, there are some other good local logistics company that has a very good secure services to, you know, to mm-hmm. transport to transport people from one state to another, but the with good services and security, but the roads are not good, the road networks are not good. So those are the challenges there. But if you are traveling within the southwest, for example, from Lagos to Ibadan or Lagos to Ogun State, the road is still accessible, and we still have maximum protection in that mm-hmm. arena.
Well, that's good. Yeah. You mentioned maximum protection. What are the security issues on the ground? Here in the West, all we ever hear about in Nigeria is Boko Haram. Would you care to comment on that? Is it as big a threat as we are led to believe here in the West?
Well, you know, like every government, there's a lot of fake news
mm-hmm.
that happens in the social media.
Right.
Which is sponsored by some of the political leaders in the country. Mm-hmm. So they fund a lot of fake news so that the world leaders or the local citizens or wherever, or the citizen of Nigeria everywhere can have can have a bad comment on the administration of the government. But
what's the social life in Nigeria like right now?
It's very accommodating, and compared to other places in the world. Like, for example, the social life here is that they encourage visitors and they interact, and there's a lot of ways of engaging in with new and foreign people. And there's no discrimination in the part of the country, especially in the old country. Mm-hmm. So the social life is impressive, and it's a welcome situation now in Nigeria.
Okay, thank you for your time.
You're welcome, sir.
All right, man. Take care, brother.
Yeah.
Bye
bye. And you too. Bye.
This is Muhammadbey. The Exodus Film Project is a series of discussions with African and African-American movers and shakers on how African-Americans can move to African countries to live peaceful, successful lives. Please support the Exodus Film Project now by contributing to our campaign at GoFundMe. Future films will address other aspects of life in African countries, such as how others are making the transitions, stories from people who've already made the transitions to life in African countries, healthcare, food, real estate, money, travel, starting a business, making contacts, retirement, the realities of residency and citizenship, and much more. Thanks for watching. Take care.